I'm going to show you how to set up and customize a new macOS user account to be sleek, snappy, and stunning. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go up here to the Finder menu, and I'm going to click on Settings. In Sidebar, I do want to turn on these areas so that they are shown on the sidebar of a Finder window. I'm also going to click on the Advanced option over here in Finder Settings, and I like to show all file name extensions so I know exactly what a file is. And then I also like to keep folders on top, so that means in a Finder window, but then also on my desktop so that folders are all lumped together in one area and then documents are below that. It makes it easier for me to find what I'm looking for. Let's go ahead and close out of Finder. Let's go to the Apple menu and click on System Settings. The first area that you're probably going to want to look at is the Notifications section. So this is where you can manage all of your notifications, and those are things that are coming up over here on the right side of your screen, but they'll also pop up when you get, say, an iMessage or something like that, but you can manage that in here as well. If we want to show previews, I actually like to turn this on never. I'll also turn them off here when the screen is locked. And I could go in and I could specify individual notifications for all of these different apps. You could do that as well if you like. Now let's go to the appearance section. I like to go with a dark theme. It's going to put a little bit less stress on your display and maybe even your eyes. So that's up to you. Do you want your wallpaper tinting in Windows? If you disable this option, you'll notice how the window appears a little bit darker. I like to turn it off. It's fresh, clean, sleek. I know that this is the window I'm working in and it's not blending in with my other windows behind it. Do we want to automatically show scroll bars? I do. It helps me know how long a particular web page or document is when I always see the scroll bar on the side. Over on the right side of the screen, we can see the scroll bar, and I could scroll, you know, with my two fingers to go down the page. However, if we go back to our settings here and we change this back to what it was automatically based on mouse or trackpad, and then we go back into Safari, you'll notice when I'm not moving my mouse, there's no scroll bar. If I mouse over the page and start scrolling, you can see it. Again, this is totally an aesthetic preference, so it's up to you, but I like to keep it on always. Okay, we're going to move on to the next area, and that is the control center. So here in the control center, we can control what items we see at the top toolbar on our computer. For a lot of these items, they're only going to be displayed when active, so we can see it up here in our top toolbar. But if we scroll down a little bit, there are some other options, and the one that I think everybody's going to want to enable is this show battery percentage. There it is, 58%. I better record this video quick or I'm going to run out of battery on this old thing. Let's move on to the next section, which is Siri and Spotlight. I have something really important for this section because if you use Spotlight, you may or may not know that Spotlight searches pretty much anything. Well, it searches all of these things in the list right here. So Spotlight we can use by going up to the magnifying glass and then typing a search query, or we can just hit Command and Spacebar and search Spotlight. However, when we search Spotlight, you'll notice we're going to access all of these different things, and sometimes we get too many results. So let's go ahead and uncheck some of these options. Calculator, conversion, definition, events and reminders, fonts, Siri suggestions, tips, and websites. By unchecking a lot of those checkboxes, we'll have a more streamlined Spotlight experience and be able to more easily find the files that we're looking for on our computer. The next section that I want to take a look at is the privacy and security section. Although there's a number of different options in here, there are two areas that I specifically want to look at. The first one is location services. So this is what apps have access to your location. If you don't want anything to have access, turn it off if you're not using location services. And the other area that I want to look at is actually scrolling down a little bit here, and it's towards the bottom. You have two areas. One is analytics and improvements and Apple advertising. Now, when you set up your computer by default, you have the option of whether you want to send analytics to Apple, and I personally just don't like doing it. Sorry, Apple, but you're getting additional information about how I use my computer. So you can make sure all of these are turned off, but hopefully you turned it off when you set up your computer. And the other one that a lot of people are interested in is how to disable targeted ads. So you'll notice we have this option called Apple Advertising, and we can go in here and we can click on, you'll notice that it says personalized ads. Once we open up either Apple News or Stocks, it's going to ask whether or not we want to receive personalized ads, at which point we could come back in here if we at one point said yes and we could disable it. Okay, now we're going to move to one of the more fun sections here in our settings, and that is the desktop and dock. Obviously, we're talking about the dock at the very bottom of the screen where we have all of the applications. We can change the size of it. We can change its magnification. One thing that I like to do is I like to enable automatically hide and show the dock. When I'm working on my computer, I don't need the dock displayed. I can just mouse over at the bottom and have it come right back up. We can also turn off animate opening applications because it just adds a little bit of stuff that we don't really need in our computer. That's up to you, but to me, it's kind of quicker without that animation. We have a number of different options here in the Desktop and Stage Manager section, and a lot of these options are new. Now, when I started this video, I enabled Stage Manager, which allows you to organize different windows on your computer. And we've actually been using Stage Manager this entire time. So right now it says, you know, when we are in Stage Manager, we are not going to show items. And this is talking about on our desktop. So you'll notice that if I hit this checkbox, now these items appear that are on my desktop. Now, they were hidden because we were in Stage Manager and we had this setting disabled. So I could have gone up here to the control panel and I could have clicked on Stage Manager to exit Stage Manager, and we would also see those items on our desktop. But this is a new option that is gaining quite some popularity, because if you're going to be using your computer and maybe you're going to have some people in your office or something and you don't want them to see this on this cluttered, messy desktop, you can go ahead and you can just come in here quickly to your settings and uncheck the show items on desktop. And boom, your desktop looks completely clean. Then your meeting is over and you can go ahead and say, okay, let's get back to work. Now there's another new feature, and that is this click wallpaper to reveal desktop. So you notice that as I've been clicking on my desktop, my windows kind of go away and it kind of opens up the desktop when I get this little gray bar around the side. This is allowing me to say, you know, hey, I'm in this application, I'm in my settings, maybe I have another window open too. What's on my desktop? Let me just click here and boom, I have access. I can click and move these files around. Now, a lot of people also find it annoying because they mistakenly are like clicking around and now their windows are flying. So if you want to disable this feature, this is where you can do it. You notice that it says click wallpaper to reveal desktop. You could set it to only in Stage Manager. So you have to first go into your control panel, enable Stage Manager, and then that clicking the desktop to move everything out of the way feature will happen. I'm going to run with it on this Sonoma install, however, because I want to get used to it. I think it's valuable. I think used alongside Stage Manager, I'll be able to organize things better. So I'm going to leave it for now. Along the same lines as showing items on our desktop, we can also decide whether or not we want to show widgets on our desktop. That's right. Apple widgets are back on Mac. So by default, we don't have any widgets on our desktop, but we're going to add some. So we can just right click on our desktop and we can go to Edit Widgets. Now from here, we could search widgets and we have all of the default widgets over here on the left. So I could go ahead and I could take this calendar widget and I could choose which one I want and I could just drag it out here to my desktop. Now, at the same time, if you are using widgets on your phone that aren't Apple widgets, so say like Spotify or something like that, if you have it installed on your iPhone and you're connected to the same Apple account on your iPhone and your computer, then you will actually see another option at the bottom that allows you to access other widgets, the ones that are on your phone, and you can now display those widgets on your Mac desktop. So now let's go back over to the settings. So now we're in these widgets settings. You'll notice that right now it says show widgets on desktop and in Stage Manager. However, we could hide it so that they're not by default shown on our desktop, but whenever we go into Stage Manager, they show up. So maybe Stage Manager is for widgets and our regular desktop is for files, or vice versa. But we are going to move on to the next section, and that is the Displays section. So down here in the Displays section, we can choose a few different things. First of all, we can choose our computer resolution, and for so long, Mac has hidden what actual resolution you're using, but no more. They've almost got it front and center, but not quite. So first of all, you'll notice that we have these resolutions, and it just says like larger and more space, but when we mouse over them, we can see that this one is 1920 by 1200, this one's 1680 by 1050, and if you right click, you can show a list. Whoa, macOS in the modern age, we have a list of screen resolutions. What, this is like Windows. Now, I'm just kidding. This feature has actually been here for a while, but it's been hidden. Now, you can also hit this other little checkbox to show all resolutions. And these are all of the resolutions that can be run on your computer by default on Mac. There are some utilities that you can install to get extra resolutions, which I'm actually using right now. But on my side, I have black bars because I want this video to be the right resolution for YouTube. So I have that installed, but you shouldn't have to worry about that. So here in the resolution section, just change it to what resolution you think looks best for your experience. You can always change it. You'll notice that you also have the option to automatically adjust brightness or not. That's based on the ambient brightness of the room that you're in. So now let's go to another fun section, and that is the wallpaper section. Okay, so here in the wallpaper section, you can obviously change your wallpaper, I want to say that if you have multiple displays, you'll have to click on the display that you want to change the wallpaper for at the top. Now, I actually like to use a lot of custom wallpapers on macOS, as you can see from my computers here. And the way to do that is to go here into the wallpaper section and then click on this Add Folder or Album dropdown, and you can click Choose Folder. Then you can create a folder on your computer somewhere, and you can put all of the wallpapers that you want to use in that folder. And that folder, once you add it, will then show up here in your list of wallpapers. So that's how you can do custom wallpapers here on macOS. All right, so now let's move over to the trackpad section. Obviously, I'm on a laptop. If you're on a computer, it will say trackpad and mouse. First of all, in this point and click area, there is secondary click. You may want to enable this on an Apple mouse as well. But you'll notice that by default, I need to have two fingers on my mouse and then click to get this little right click background. However, some people don't like that. So here in the system settings, you can change that to be click in the bottom right corner or click in the bottom left corner, however you want it set up. But that's how you can control your right click. Now, the second thing that might be frustrating some of you is in this scroll and zoom section. You'll notice that by default, this natural scrolling option is enabled. And for me, for whatever reason, I think Apple has it backwards and it just doesn't feel right to me. I'm trying to scroll down and I'm scrolling up. You know, it's the opposite. So disable natural scrolling and you'll now scroll the way that you want to if it feels like it's been backwards so far on Mac. All right, we're done with the macOS settings, but let's go down to our dock and right click to remove all of these icons that we no longer want on our dock. You can always add them in at a later date just by searching for the application in Spotlight and then dragging it back onto your dock. You can also drag recently used applications like Google Chrome from the recently used application sections into the main dock so that they'll always be there later on. Now your dock is fresh, clean, and customized. That's how you can set up a new sleek and snappy macOS user account. If you want a more in-depth guide on everything there is to know about macOS, don't forget to check out this video right here. If you found the video that you're watching right now helpful, I would really appreciate a thumbs up here on YouTube. And if you want to see more Mac content like this, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. That's all I have for you for today, everyone. I'm Anson Alexander, and I will see you in the next one.